What's going on, y'all? It's your boy Mission Mike. So I'm currently right now in Ocala, Florida. My wife, Janelle, she's back there. She's like working on stuff right now. But anyways, I just felt like sharing something with y'all. So I've been traveling full-time and just on this full-time mission of mine for like over 6 years now, maybe more. I don't even know. I haven't had a traditional job in like several years. And even I don't know how I've like made it this far. But I figured I want to share at least like one tip that's kind of like burning in my heart right now. And I guess what that would be is, if there's one trick or one tool that will serve you really well for those of you out there who are currently traveling or maybe starting it, or maybe mostly for those of y'all who are out there like really wanting to start, it is the art of step by step. Okay? That's simple. It's that whole eat an elephant a bite at a time. I know it's like cliche, but it's like I've learned how true that is as I have gone. You know, there are seasons where you're facing something. Maybe the season you're at right now is like, how do I even start traveling? Maybe that's the question right now. How can I travel full time? Well, if you kind of take that whole problem and chop it up into pieces, into sections of your journey, it has a start, it has the middle, all the conflict, it has the finish. I guess that's, you know, when we all die, it's inevitable, 10 out of 10, we're all gonna reach that point. But, or maybe the end of that journey until a new chapter of life, whatever, but the beginning is start, right? So let's isolate, just start up to the front of the line, and let's figure out maybe that's where you need to start. And focus on is, how do you launch? And honestly, y'all, I remember I started preparing for almost like 2 years worth of like, I thought I needed to buy the right gear. I thought I needed to get this, that. You start trying to gather up all the like gear, the whatever. Sorry if it's loud right now, we're currently at Starbucks. But anyways, I was like trying to gather up everything that I needed, all the gear, all the right stuff, all the blah, blah, blah. And when I launched, I swear I got rid of everything almost. You think you need a lot, but you don't. So for those of you trying to start, then I'm just gonna just throw out there, just start. If you got a certain job, just quit, okay? Or pick a day on your calendar when you're leaving, or figure out what you think you need. But like in reality, it's superior to launch with money and not the right gear than the right gear and no money. Okay, that's a mistake I made. I thought I had certain gear that I was gonna need, and once you get out there and you start problem solving, you realize it's like so night and day. Here's an example. If you're watching a bunch of van build videos, all of them have, the funniest thing of all is water. Everybody puts bathrooms, showers, sinks, etc. Where do you think you get this water from? Let me tell you, when I was traveling, it is a nightmare getting water, which you'll be doing every other day. If you're not staying in an RV place, which gets expensive, is you'll be going into a Walmart and buying these big 5-gallon jugs. You got a big rig, you may need multiple, pushing your cart back and forth. Unless you can find a land with a hookup, or if you stay at an RV lot, you ain't never gonna have any water. And then you're gonna be hauling around a big jug. It's like, so that's just a point to say that you think you know what you need, but it's not till you start that you really begin realizing what you need, which brings us to the next point, the whole step-by-step concept. Each and every day is going to present its problems. And if you're too far ahead in solving your own problems, if you're looking to solve the future, that will trip you up more than anything when it comes to solving the present. So if I had some advice, do not look at the future. Don't ask yourself, don't ask like, okay, how can I travel full time for the next 10 years? Do not look at 10 years. I'm serious. Just look at today. So maybe that's launching, or maybe you're on the road, or maybe you're kind of wondering what the start's gonna look like. But it's like, let me tell y'all, to this, we're here right now grabbing coffee, and I am still, to this day, solving what's next. If anything, one of the best things you can do is schedule a quiet time or a meditative time or a problem-solving time in your day. It's kind of like this concept of when you create the time and the space in your schedule to be able to problem solve, it's amazing how many problems, you know, you start solving. Even if it's not in a day, maybe it takes a few days, maybe it takes a few weeks, whatever, but it's like, I got to the point where I started going to a coffee shop, like local coffee shops, almost every single day, and to the point where it evolved into every day. It doesn't have to be a coffee shop. You don't have to be bougie or snobby or snooty or the Mexicans out there, chocante, you know, it's like just having some type of time, whether it's in the morning, maybe it's at your own place or where you're staying or where you think you'll be staying, even in your own vehicle. I mean, you can go to a park and you get hot water from a gas station, go to a park and make French press coffee for next to nothing. You know what I mean? And you can get whatever. But the point is, when you sit down and you have this time, that's where you create your problem solving. And then what you do is you look at that ladder you're climbing or that mountain, and you look at the step that you're facing, you put that on the table and you just tinker with it until you solve it. That may take a little while. There may be moments where you got to step back and rethink the problem, or maybe you walk away from it and then all of a sudden you get a chance to decompress and you'll solve it. But nevertheless, one step at a time. If you can have the mentality of just one step at a time, like, it's silly right now, but like when we, for example, when you travel, towels, okay? They take up a lot of room. They take a long time to dry. If you go to, whether you stay at a friend's, a hotel, or a gym, or whatever, you know, a lot of you, if you're gonna be doing vehicle life, you'll probably be using gyms. Your towel takes a long time to dry, okay? So, for example, we were like, hey, quick dry towels, polyester towels, found them on Amazon. Haven't ordered them yet, but it's funny how it's like, it's the little things, you know, that's like an example of a problem that we can solve. Once you solve that and you get a step further, then it's like, what's the problem gonna be after that? And inevitably you'll reach this point of equilibrium where you've solved almost all your problems and now life is beginning to sustain. So it's like you climb, level out. Now you're equilibrium. Now you have a functioning lifestyle. That's what happened to me with travel. Solve the problem. I started with the basics of like, how am I gonna pay for it? What do I eat today? You know, so it started with like, here's a little story for you. I started with, had this guitar. I didn't have an amp. I didn't have equipment. I didn't know how to play, but I ran into, how am I gonna eat? And I was stuck on that problem for a minute. Finally, I just picked that guitar up and I was like, I guess I'm just gonna play this until I can make a few bucks. And I played for hours and made $7 for probably 6 hours of playing, 7 to 8 hours of playing. And this went on for a while and it sucked, but then I got a little better and a little better and a little better. Fast forward years into the journey, I ended up somehow going across to the other side of the country, landed at Santa Monica Pier, and every day I'd go out. I would like play music. I would not preach to any of you unbelievers. Freaking love you guys. Half the mission and the friends and the team is non-Christian, so got love for y'all. And so anyways, but I would go out there and sometimes pray over people, read scripture, just jam, sing overly depressing music, whatever. But like, it got to the point where that was sustaining me. So it's like, you'll figure out your rhythm, you'll figure out your routine. But it's like, if you're wanting to travel, if you're trying to figure out how to even begin, let me tell you right now, you just start. The sooner you start, the better. Because every person almost I've ever met, whatever their journey was, whether they were van lifers, whether they were entrepreneurs, whether they were martial artists, like Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belts, every single one of them just say, you gotta start. You just begin at one point. It's that simple. And as you begin and you take that, the first step, the hardest, the scariest of all, but also your favorite probably ever, and you take that first step of starting, the next step will present itself, and then you'll figure out how to solve that. So just step by step, launch step by step. And that's whatever the journey is. That may go for travel, that may go for a relationship, landing my wife when I courted her. You know, if you had asked me how you're gonna win her over, I had no freaking clue. I just knew I was gonna win her over. And same thing, every single day was another step. Martial arts, you wanna get a freaking black belt, same thing. You wanna get a blue belt, you know, it doesn't matter what it is or what's going on. So that's what I had as an encouragement. That's what it would be. So if this was helpful, I got a favor to ask. Okay. I want you to help feed your fellow man. And you can do that by going to missionmike.com. I gotta do the plug. Me and my wife, we're running a 501c3 nonprofit, and the whole point of it is just getting scripture out there, food, whatever you gotta do to like help other people out there. That's what we're all about. Like literally, all profits are going to like charity to others. And like I said, 50% of the people who do it are unbelievers. So if you didn't find this helpful, you don't hurt my feelings. But if you did and you appreciate it, I swear even $1, 10 bucks, that goes to like feeding someone. So that's kind of our way of helping others. So again, that's one of the best ways we get out there and we can help people, and that you can as well and be part of it. So missionmike.com, love you guys. We'll talk to you soon.